Hello and welcome everyone. After a tooth has erupted into the oral cavity, it takes about 3 years for the root development to complete. Hence, the root of the tooth still has thin dentinal walls and an open root end. When the pulp of such a tooth that is still undergoing root development is exposed to the environment, and if the pulp becomes necrosed, then the root dentine formation will cease and the root development will become arrested. The result will be a short thin root with thin dentinal walls and a comparatively large apex that lacks constriction, and this is known as an open apex. This tooth, because of the thin root and the dead pulp, can easily be fractured and is very weak. In addition to that, open apex provides a serious challenge in the treatment of the tooth, because conventional root canal treatment is not an option since apical closure hasn't been achieved yet, and therefore root canal treatment becomes unpredictable and unreliable in these cases. Hence, protecting the vitality of the pulp in such developing teeth is really important in order to promote continued root development and achieve apical end closure. A number of procedures have been suggested to counter this problem. One of the such procedures is Apexogenesis. Apexogenesis, in the 10th edition of Glossary of Endodontics, is defined as a vital pulp therapy procedure performed to encourage continued physiological development and formation of the root end. The objective of Apexogenesis is to maintain the vitality of the radicular pulp after a pulp exposure has occurred so that the root can continue developing and the apical closure can be achieved. And today in this video, we shall be discussing the procedure of Apexogenesis and what are the outcomes of such procedure. So what is the procedure of Apexogenesis? After successful anesthesia and isolation of the tooth, the inflamed or the damaged tissue is removed. There are two ways to remove the pulp. One of them involves partial removal of the pulp in a procedure known as civex pulpotomy. In civex pulpotomy, only a superficial 2 to 4 mm of pulp is removed. It has been demonstrated that for up to 168 hours after the traumatic incident has occurred, the inflammation is limited to the most superficial 2 mm of the pulp. Hence, in these cases, partial pulpotomy, or also known as civex pulpotomy, should be attempted. When there is a larger exposure or the pulp was exposed for a very long time, then conventional pulpotomy can be done, in which coronal pulp is removed at the level of apical constriction. Hemorrhage is then controlled by applying pressure on a cotton pellet moistened with saline. Failure to achieve hemostasis at this stage may indicate that inflamed tissue still remains and more pulp needs to be removed. The exposed pulp is then rinsed with 1.25% sodium hypochlorite. A material is placed over the exposed pulp. Mineral trioxide or MTA is now the recommended material, although traditionally calcium hydroxide was widely used, but now it is being replaced by MTA. MTA is prepared immediately before use by mixing powder with sterile water or saline in a ratio of 3:1. The mixture is then placed on the exposed pulp and patted in place with a moist cotton pellet. Because MTA sets in the presence of moisture over a 3-hour long period, a wet cotton pellet is placed over the material and the cavity is filled with a temporary restoration material. After the MTA has set, the final restoration can be placed. The patient should be recalled every 6 months. At every visit, the pulp vitality is tested, signs and symptoms are observed, and the radiographs are taken to observe the continued root development. Apexogenesis can be very successful if correct case is selected and if the procedure is done correctly. Hence, case selection for apexogenesis is also a very crucial part. That brings us to our next heading, that what is an ideal case for apexogenesis. Because not every developing tooth having a pulpar exposure with an open apex is ideal for apexogenesis. A tooth having an open apex which was symptomless before the exposure or had mild signs and symptoms of reversible pulpitis is the ideal tooth that should be treated with apexogenesis. Because the pulp in reversible pulpitis can be reversed back to normal state if the cause of inflammation is removed. But if the tooth prior to exposure had signs and symptoms of irreversible pulpitis, which is mostly the case when the pulp exposure has been caused by caries, then attempting apexogenesis in these cases is useless, since the pulp will eventually go into necrotic state regardless of whether the irritants are removed or not. Same goes for a tooth already having a necrotic pulp. In these teeth, there is no healthy pulp present that can continue the root development. For these type of teeth, apexification rather than apexogenesis is the recommended treatment option. I will be talking about apexification in my later videos, but let's just continue on apexogenesis. It is also recommended that the exposure ideally should be treated as early as possible. A small exposure can be treated with direct pulp capping, in which MTA is placed directly over the small exposed part, hence avoiding the need for apexogenesis. But if the exposure is large, then apexogenesis should be attempted. So what is the goal of apexogenesis? The primary goal of apexogenesis is to maintain the pulp vitality, therefore allowing dentine formation and root end closure. By keeping the pulp alive in apexogenesis, the remaining odontoblast can continue depositing dentine, increasing the thickness of root dentinal walls and making it less prone to fracture. So in the end, let's just briefly discuss what are the different outcomes of apexogenesis. So the ideal outcome of apexogenesis therapy is the continued apical growth of the root with normal pulp. The pulp may remain vital for indefinite periods of time, therefore root canal treatment after root end closure has been achieved is not recommended. Apexogenesis also has a good success rate with partial pulpotomy or cervix pulpotomy, since more of the healthy pulp is still left in the tooth. After a conventional pulpotomy in which almost entire coronal pulp is removed, the success rate of apexogenesis is low and calcific metamorphosis is a common occurrence. Calcific metamorphosis is the filling of pulpal space with hard tissue formation. But according to most views, even after calcific metamorphosis is evident on the radiograph, root canal treatment is not recommended since calcific metamorphosis itself is not a pathological condition. I've talked more about calcific metamorphosis in detail in my pulp calcification video. But if the pulp becomes necrotic in the future and the canals are no longer negotiable for a root canal treatment because of the calcific metamorphosis, then surgery would be necessary. If it is determined that pulp has become irreversibly inflamed or dead due to necrosis before the root could complete development, then apexification must be initiated at this stage. I will talk more about apexification in my later videos. So I hope you liked this video and you found this video helpful. As always, take care of yourselves and your loved ones. Stay safe and goodbye.